fabric is now through the printer. I've loaded it into the printer. And it drops down, and I've completely left it right here because there's a couple steps that I recommend doing to make the fabric run well. First, I don't necessarily take this loading device off yet. The reason why is it's providing me with a little weight. And I think having a little weight on there is a good thing. It's also applying the weight fairly evenly. The weight is effectively acting like tension. So I'm going to keep that on there, provided that during the loading it didn't get unsettled or didn't pull away from the fabric in some way, and that does happen. So everything on there is still nice and even. And I have slack actually back here. It is not fully tensioned all the way through. I haven't done anything yet. Now the printer and the interface here is asking me what material is in there. I'm not going to tell it just yet. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that before any steps from here onward, that this fabric is perfectly loaded, is nice and straight to the core, and has almost no skew to it before I even go to the next step. So the first thing I do right here is I lift this lever, which is going to release the pinch rollers. Now, if you look, and you guys can't quite see because of the camera, but if you look in the print path here, you can see that it is bunched up on this corner. If the print head were to come out right now, it would clearly catch this roll on this edge. So you don't want to be having any sort of carriage movement to the print head coming out there yet. Not such a great idea. The first thing I do is I lift the tension right here, and that immediately straightens everything out. Everything goes completely flat because there's no tension kind of pushing it down and causing the edges to bunch up and to pop. Then I'm going to stand here in the middle and I'm going to pull this down, lift this up, and make sure the edge guards are out of the way. I don't want them involved at this point. I don't want them to get caught. I don't want them to be sort of, affecting the path of this fabric yet. I'll put this down again. I have these nice long arms, and I'm going to pull this out until all the slack is out, and then stand here and look and kind of figure out visually, am I right on the mark where the edges of the media is exactly lined up where the roll is. I am visually determining the skew. Now, if you have a reference point and the fabric is right up against the core and you can use one of these blue lines here, that's helpful. But you definitely want to make sure, before I put that pinch roller back down again and then go into the control panel and tell it what it is, I want to make sure everything is just right. That's very key. Because if it's not lined up right and that print head comes out, that's going to catch the fabric. And I don't want the fabric to be caught. Now, you can see these undulations here on this fabric. So I am going to use the edge guards on this fabric. I use edge guards very sparingly. There's not a lot of materials I put the edge guards on. But in this case, I think I'm going to need them because that kind of little waves on the edge of the fabric is going to go through the print carriage. And if one of them is just high enough, the carriage is going to come out and it's going to catch it or it's going to touch it. And if it touches it, sometimes it kind of pulls it up a little. And now the second pass is going to be worse. So I need to make sure that those are held down. If they're too aggressive, they're not going to hold down. The pinch, the edge guard is going to hold on it, and they're still going to pop up in front and behind it, and it's not going to fix the problem. In those cases, I usually walk away from the media, or if you're clever and can devise some sort of aftermarket way to hold it down with some other product, fine. I have people doing that. I have a little set of my own. But the general rule is, don't use that fabric. It's not cut right on the edges, and it's not going to work. All right. Looking at it, I can see that I'm on the roll nice and even. I give it another tug. I give a visual inspection of everything, and now we're ready to go. I'm going to drop this lever. Oh, that's right. I said I'll put the edge guards on. I'm going to put them on a little in more from the white line. Want them to have a little more of an effect. I'm going to drop this lever. And then I'm going to choose fabric or textile. And right now it's not in the printer, so I'm going to choose none of these and hit continue. Now, as soon as you hit continue, this thing is starting to roll forward. Now it says remove loading accessory. Now, since it's already down here, the weight from this accessory is not going to have much effect, so you can take it off. For the video we're doing, we'll just leave it on. But you can take it off because it's not really doing much at this point. What I do recommend doing at this point is if you need two people, get two people. I can do it with one because I have long arms. I'm going to stand in front of this machine and I am going to babysit this print, this fabric, until I can get it on the take-up roll. I want to make sure that going forward and backward, that I'm going to hold it on the edges and get it through its process until I can apply tension. Once I apply tension with a take-up roll, pretty much it rolls forward, no troubles. It's autonomous at that point. But right now, it still might need some assistance. So I'm not going to walk away from this like a banner or an adhesive vinyl, because this fabric still needs some attention, and I have to make sure that when it rolls forward and back here, it's not going to get caught by the print carriage that comes out. So as soon as I hit OK, now the printer is checking the winding direction, and I'm going to stand on these edges, and it helps sometimes to have two people. We're going to make sure and watch it closely and make sure that it can't get caught on anything. Sometimes fabric likes to move forward, but it doesn't like to move backward. And when it moves backward, it kind of bunches at the pin troller. Those are things to be aware of when you're loading. And this is all really just related to loading the fabric. So now it wants me to lift the lever. And it wants me to align the right edge. Now, fabric may never have the skew tolerances that other materials have. You know, they're always going to be on the roll a little bit uneven, so I'm a little more forgiving about skews. Sometimes I just override the skew rejection if I think it's on there evenly. It's not like adhesive vinyl where everything is perfectly on the edge of the material and it travels in a perfectly straight line. Fabric is always going to have a little bit of movement, so it may need a slightly larger skew tolerance to be approved. So it's asked me to lift the lever. I'm going to lift the lever, and now it's checking the width. So the print head is coming out, and here it comes. And I hold down those edges and make sure that nothing can happen there. It's telling me you've loaded one that's not in the library. That's fine. I'm not going to look for it right now. I'm going to hit no, and it sees it. So the fabric now is ready to load onto the take-up roll. But I want to make sure that load-in process, pay attention. It's not banner. It doesn't work on its own. Some fabrics need some assistance, and they need you to watch it while it loads. So it's on the edge guards. I can see it kind of undulating. Once I get the tension on, I think it'll be enough to overcome that. It says that it's 61.3 inches. That next step is your take-up core. You want to make sure, ideally, that your take-up core is a little bit longer than your fabric. If it is shorter than the fabric, that can pose problems. Because you're putting this fabric onto a core, and if the fabric goes over it like this, that sort of weakness can cause it to travel up and create some issues. It is my recommendation that since I have a 61-inch media on here, I want like a 62-inch or a 63-inch core. I have cores that are 63 and 64 inches specifically for fabric. The other thing I do not do is on the take-up reel, I do not use the edge caps for fabric. The fabric needs to walk a little bit, you know, so when it moves, it's going to kind of move along this edge. And I don't want it to get caught up on that edge cap, the spindle cap. It's going to cause problems. So just put this directly on the spindle in the middle and then tape the fabric to the take-up core, load it onto the take-up reel, initiate the take-up reel so it knows it's on there, and you're good to go. I'm going to show you a couple other tricks here on how to get it onto this core so that it stays on there stable. But do try to make this a little bit longer. That will make your life a little bit easier. That way you have room to walk on it and you're not right up against the edge.